Most aspects of web performance can be measured in a consistent way for comparison and analysis and iteration. There are a myriad of tools out there for this purpose, including tools built into your browser and online tools you can use either for free or for a fee. Different tools give you different types of feedback, and because they exist in different locations, on different stacks, and provide different types of services, they also give you slightly different results compared to one another. For this reason, the best practice is to use several different performance monitoring tools, collect the data from all of them, and then compare, contrast, and analyze when possible. These tools fall into two main categories, browser tools and hosted third-party tools. Let's look at the browser tools first. There are two main types of tools here. The first one exists inside the Chrome browser. If you open the developer tools for Chrome and go to the far right-hand side of the developer tools, there's a button called Lighthouse. This tool generates a performance report for your site, and it also gives you a long list of suggestions on how to improve the performance of your site. It also tests for other things, progressive web apps, best practices, accessibility, and SEO, and you can choose whether you want to test on a mobile device or a desktop device. If you choose mobile, then the browser will mimic a mobile device, so small screens, slower load times, and all that. So I'm going to generate a report just to see what's going on this site that I'm running right now. This is a site that lives somewhere on the web, but you can also run Lighthouse on a locally hosted site on your computer if you want to. What I get in response here is a performance score of 84. This is good, but not great. Ideally, I want to get as close as possible to 100. I want it to at least be in the green, so over 90. To fix that, I can now scroll down and see what's slowing my site down. Well, first off, I can see there are some issues. First, contentful paint is too slow. Largest contentful paint is too slow. And there's too much cumulative layout shift, meaning things are moving too much around as the page is loaded. Scrolling further down, we get a list here of opportunities and diagnosis. So the opportunities here include eliminate render blocking resources. If I open that, you can see the render blocking resource in question is Google Fonts. You can also see it says serve images in next-gen formats. And if we open up, it'll say image formats like JPEG 2000, JPEG XR, and WebP often provide better compression than PNGs and JPEGs. And finally, at the bottom here, we have remove unused JavaScript. And that just means somewhere in the sites, there's JavaScript being loaded that isn't being used, which is a waste of resources. So the Lighthouse report is really good at seeing at a glance where the performance enhancements of your site can be, and it gives you good recommendations on what to do. If you want to dig further into exactly what is going on in your site, you can also run the network monitor. You open the network monitor, make sure you click disable cache so that you are downloading the site from scratch, and then you just reload the page. What you get here is a waterfall of every single resource that's being downloaded from the site, and you can see right away how it's being downloaded. Now, in this case, the site is running HTTP 2, meaning it's multiplexing and loading resources as fast as they become available. And you can see here that it takes quite a bit of time for everything to load. For example, we have this file here called vendor.js. Now, this is the file that Lighthouse said has a lot of unused code. And you can see it takes quite a while to load, and there's a lot of execution going on here too. Further down, we have main.js. If you hover over any of these, you get a breakdown of how long it takes for queuing, how long it was stalled, how long it took for the request to be sent, and how much wait time happened before it came back, how long it takes to download. So here you see, for example, it took 237.99 milliseconds between the request was sent to the server and the response came back. And then the actual download was only 1.49 milliseconds. If we look at the top one here, this is the HTML document. You can also see there's a very slow start on the server. So the server waited for 1.48 milliseconds before anything happened. And then we waited 151 milliseconds before the file actually got downloaded. So the total execution of this was 153.9 milliseconds, which is a very long time. That means that the server that it's running on is not all that fast. If you want to go even deeper into what's going on, you can also go to the performance monitor. Now, the performance monitor tells you about how the scripts and everything else in the site are actually performing, but it's worth knowing about because it gives you a lot of details about what's going on in your site. Again, to run it, you need to go over here, clear everything, and then click on Start Profiling and Reload Page. Now the page will be reloaded into the browser and the profiler starts. Now, the profiler is a fairly advanced tool, and you can use it to do things like profile existing behaviors. You can go in and mess around with a site and then see what is happening. But what you get here is now very detailed information about how the page is loaded and what kind of activity happens as it's loaded. So you can see there's 20 milliseconds for loading, then 83 for scripting, and 38 for rendering, and 12 for painting. And you can see here in the breakdown exactly when different things happen and what is happening and so on. So there's a lot of information here. Lighthouse exists in Chrome. Network Monitor and Performance Monitor exists in all modern browsers, including Firefox, Edge, and so on. The second category of performance monitoring tools is hosted third-party tools. The most used example here is PageSpeed Insights. Now, if we go to PageSpeed Insights, you'll notice it looks exactly the same as Lighthouse, just that it's on the web. That's because it is. The difference is Lighthouse runs on your computer. PageSpeed Insights runs on some server that Google has, so you get slightly different data, and you get slightly more reliable data because it's also compared to other data that they have. But this is a way you can run Lighthouse on any website, even if you don't have Chrome, and you get the same type of breakdown, same type of tips, and everything else. One cool thing is the PageSpeed Insights screenshots are not reliant on the browser window. You may have noticed in my Lighthouse output here that the screenshots are based on the size of my browser window. So right now we're just getting the hamburger menu. Well, in PageSpeed Insights, you get the actual screens. You can see what's going on. Another popular tool is the web page test website. Again, here you just enter the website you want to test and you get a report in return. And you get a full breakdown of the waterfall. You get different runs, so you can run the same site against different browsers, different configurations, different locations to see how it differs. So the difference between run one and run two here is run one is the first load, run two is the cached load. So the website is already being cached inside the system, and you get a ton of information. Regardless of what testing procedure you use, browser tools, hosted third-party tools, or something else, the actual test results always include page speed scores and other details. They also show you key indicators describing the user experience, most important of which are first paint, the time it takes before the user sees changes happening in the browser, largest contentful paint, the time it takes before the user sees content, so text, images, something else in the browser, first meaningful paint, the time it takes before the user sees content that is actually meaningful, so when above the full content and web fonts are loaded and the user can derive meaning from what they are seeing, and finally, time to interactive, the time it takes before the content has finished loading and the UI can be interacted with, so the user can actually click on buttons, fill forms, or do whatever else is going to happen on the site. The longer it takes for a site to hit each of these points, the higher the chance of the user either getting annoyed or abandoning the user experience altogether. As an example, I'm sure you've experienced visiting a site on your computer or mobile device and experiencing not being able to click on a button or interact with an input field. In that circumstance, you're still waiting for TTI, or time to interactive, and that wait can be extremely infuriating. When it comes to reliable automated testing, Lighthouse is currently the industry standard, and it's even integrated in other hosted solutions like GT Metrics and PageSpeed Insights. Lighthouse also gives you other important feedback like accessibility testing and recommendations on more performant JavaScript libraries and so on. So for ongoing testing during development, Lighthouse is by far the quickest and most reliable route.